Cycling fan, thanks for tuning in. Today, going to be talking about the new 2020 race calendar, the revised race calendar, and the Australian National Road Series race calendar. Can we really expect racing to resume in August of this year? Almost 1,000 races have been postponed because of the worldwide crisis. The UCI have confirmed the Tour de France for August 29 to September 20, the Giro d'Italia, October 3rd to 25th, and the España sometime October, November. And the Copa Classics packed into October. But are international borders going to open by August? August is 3 months off. Can anyone confirm that international travel is going to be allowed in Europe, especially into Spain? Or France, Italy. We know that some restrictions have been lifted, that you can now ride outside, but social distancing still applies. It is speculation to think that the races will start again on 13th of August. If racing does resume in July, that's only 2 months away. That would be a very quick turnaround on lifting restrictions. And if riders need to travel into France, into the Netherlands, into Italy, Norway, Belgium, will they need 2 weeks quarantine? Should have they travelled now? Normally, riders would go to the Critérium Dauphiné and then on to the Tour de France, but will they need to do 2 weeks quarantine before they can race? How will they restrict spectators at the Tour de France on a 212-kilometre stage? Will it be up to the individual to social distance themselves from other spectators? Is there any liability there for the UCI and for the race organisers? We don't know. All these governments have not said, yes, this will go ahead, yes, we will lift restrictions. So where does that leave us? Where does that leave the riders? A lot of these riders are backing that the Tour de France is going to go ahead, that they will get a chance to race, which will help them confirm their contract for 2021. In Australia, domestic travel is still not allowed. The Australian government don't see this reopening possibly till August or beyond. Some states are in no rush to open their borders. So can you publish a calendar to say these races may go ahead in September or in October? The Queensland government have said they're unlikely to open their borders before September. This is a real problem. Should racing be put on hold until 2021? I'm not suggesting it should. Some riders rely on racing and their contracts to feed their family. It is a very tough position. everyone. There's no easy answers. I think that it's interesting, but that both the UCI have come out to say that, yes, we are going to race. I think they're hoping they will, but have they been in talks with the government of those countries? And is there special dispensation for professional riders to be able to perform their jobs? Can they go to the government and request permission? I don't think so, but we don't know. I hope that before the end of June that they've come out in this firm statements as to when and if racing may resume in both the UCI World Tour and also Australia. So should we be relying on Zwift? The NRS, National Road Series, have their races on Zwift, invite only, for all the attention that it is receiving. It's quite good racing. The USA, they've had the Redlands Bicycle Classic, and this weekend the Tour of Gila, because the Tour of Gila and the Redlands Bicycle Classic weren't able to go ahead. And the same USA pro teams have entered both races. And it's very hard. People are still getting to race. In some respects, they're getting more spectators through a Zwift race than what they would be if they were racing on the road, especially in Australia. NRS races don't get 15,000 spectators, but on Zwift you do. It's an interesting position that the world finds itself in. It's an interesting position that riders find themselves in. What are they training for? Should the UCI say a blanket no to 2020 and resume in 2021? But again, where does that leave riders? And contracts at the end of the year that you need to be able to find another contract. Same goes in the NRS series. I guess we'll find out in the coming weeks and the possible months. I hope that racing does resume because we want to see the classics, we want to see the Tour de France, the Vuelta, the Giro. We want to see racing in Australia resume at club and at national level. Let's hope that we find out soon.